a bigger difference between how things were in the ghetto and how things were by the end of the 19th century, and how you can start seeing the problems of the 20th century. Now, today, we're blessed. We have this incredible property. We have a collection of 25,000 works of art. We have 400, as I was saying earlier, we have 450,000 visitors. A characteristic, I think, of English heritage properties is that they tend to look backwards. And our ambition here is much more to look forwards, or to accompany the past at least. And we care passionately about climate change. And how does that reflect itself? Well, we built this building 12 years ago, and we convene here and talk about these issues. So we did one at the Smith School in Oxford. We've done others, and about 10 years ago now, we did a thing with Oxford University with Pilkins and David Attenborough to talk about climate change. But the problem, I'm afraid, gets bigger and bigger and bigger, and harder and harder to deal with. I mean, if you take, it reminds me a little bit of the problems of Corona, because if you take China, I mean, a few years ago, they were 3% of carbon emissions. Today, they're 27%. And we all mind. But then you say to yourself, well, at the same time, they took 2 billion people the woman is absolutely sure of is that there's an immense amount to do, and we're trying quite hard of actual bit of that, the farming side.
Of course. It's so interesting hearing about the historical context of the family, because of course our interest in climate change goes back many hundreds of years. If you think about your grandfather Charles, my great grandfather, who after was one of the first conservationists in the world. Do you remember his story and how he started? Because it's rather amazing.
Charles, well, yes, I mean, Charles, wasn't it? He was the father figure of the Nature Conservancy. 1914 was a famous meeting at the National History Museum when he put his hat into the ring. Bought a large nature reserve, and from then on there were 284 more. So he was a crucial figure, and our side of the family, that's been consistent because the elder brother Walter is a very eccentric commander. Walter Rothschild, who built the museum at Tring. He devotes his life to that. So there was that strong tradition which is carried on by my Miriam, who also devoted her life to wildlife and nature. My father's a scientist, so you see increasing concerns in the century, and that's expensive banking. But equally now, of course, one of the things in addition to the measure I very briefly How can we invest our resources to good effect to help this planet change? And I think there are any number of ways that you can support them to capital and people who are taking work on initiatives. Our dream is if you look across this building, you build it on the other side. But one day that will become a center of, say, agriculture technology and tech, and a venture capital, which will help with climate change. So this place behind will become a center for those activities. Let me be frank, we've come to that conclusion, helped us by the evidence that's been mounting at us decades. But also, frankly, I think because of the initiatives made
by So I think picking up from something that you've said, I think we feel as a family that we're custodians of the land. We don't own it. We're not here to maximize our returns. What we feel is that we've got to leave it in a better shape for the next generation. And once upon a time, I think there was a kind of pressure, you know, that people who were seen as climate change activists or people who wanted to farm in that way had to wear sackcloth and eat lentils and, you know, chips around in the moonlight. But actually, what we've discovered here through our farming practices on the 5,000 acres around where we're sitting is that you can do an enormous amount to regenerate soil, actually in-house. So, for example, we harvest our rainwater. We make sure that the 750,000 meters of hedgerow are properly planted to help insects and together as sunlight. And we make this wonderful microbiome. Mixture that we put back into the soil.
We're never going to just even build what the United States needs.
Cereal and pour a whole lot of chemicals. the opportunity to make a difference. And we're doing it. But we're not kind of doing it at Marie Antoinette Petit Piano way. We're actually producing doing it in a sustainable, regenerative way.
If it makes a profit, we give it. And we also, if it does make a profit, it does sometimes, we give it that profit.
And I love the fact that you are so forward thinking, you know, in business. So I love the fact that we're thinking about creating agritech center over there. That we're actually using, for example, the latest technology, say the drones. So we're using drones to fly over the land to see where one might need a chemical, but it's only used in a tiny, tiny, tiny amount. Because drone technology can help us.
I mean, I see the phenomenal change. Coming back in the last 2-3 years is the probably isn't a child of the age of 6 that isn't deeply concerned about there were reports in the past, but now the papers in the world are on their problems, whether it's drugs, whether it's storms, whether it's the seaside being ruined, just undermining life,
everything. And in a way, Corona has slightly, I'm afraid, eclipsed the importance of this conversation. No one's saying Corona isn't incredibly devastating, but actually we do need to think long term about the planet.
Yeah, and it's a distraction, well, more than a distraction, it's a tragedy, but it does have that knock-on effect.
Well, I would hope that the vision that we are coming up with here, which is that we've got land which we can look after very well, and set an example. You know, not in a positive surprising way, but I hope in an attraction rather than promotion. We've got these extraordinary buildings, one of which we're sitting in now, and one, as you pointed out, where we can convene the latest and the greatest thinkers, thanks to people like Bloomberg Green and others. Other organizations, so that we can bring, and we've got history, so we can bring those three strands together, I think, and try and make a difference. It's incredible work. And Bloomberg Green is done. Having everyone here, but what we really want
great opportunity.
It's really exciting. It would be fantastic.
Doodle, papa doodle.